Jared Rowe.
Yes, sir.
What's up, bro? You been on camera before?
Shit, yeah.
You did some TV before?
A little something.
Nah, man. How you feeling? Everything all right?
I'm feeling good. Focus. Already.
I mean, I'm gonna be real quick, man, but maybe I'm overdoing it, but I think you might not the number one prospect here, bro. I think you the number one kid. I mean, that's what I'm telling all schools, man. Sorry. Not trying to gas you. No, I mean, but you got it. What you think about the 40 tomorrow?
I'm running.
Okay.
I'm running.
You feeling good? You feeling good with it? Okay, because this, I would say you probably should run it too, because this is your leg's gonna be the freshest to run a 40. Exactly. So other camps, you can say, okay, I got this on time, things like that, man. But man, just do what the fuck you been doing, man. It's simple as that, bro. Mm-hmm. You gotta, like, I'm gonna introduce you to every DB coach there prior. All you gotta really do is show something, man, and you're gonna get a lot of buzz there. People know who you are already. They're coming to see you. You gotta run in the high 4.5s at least tomorrow. You got to. Well, all right, low, but you gotta at least run a high 4.5 tomorrow, man. A 4.6 will still get you in the door, but a 4.5 is gonna kick it down, man. You gotta confirm their offers, man. I'm telling you, you don't have, some of these guys gotta be amazing. You don't have to be amazing. You just have to be better than average. But you just gotta be good. Seriously, like, you ain't even got so much pressure on you like some of these other kids, but if you wanna play at these powerhouse schools, man, then you gotta fucking show up, man.
Yes, sir.
You good?
Yeah.
See you in the morning, man.
Appreciate
you. Much love, bro. I was a little nervous on what he run. I mean, I know if he run 4.5, he'll get scholarships, but I know if he run 4.6, it'd be a little tougher. So back in my mind, I just didn't want him to lose opportunities if he ran slower. So I was a little nervous for the first camp. Should he run his 40 or not? Should he just do position drills? But I went up to him and asked him, was he ready? And he gave me a look, and I mean.
Runners, ready.
He ran mid 4.4, I believe it 4.46 at the Mercer camp, and kind of boosted his recruiting from there.
I'll tell him.
Hey, Gyro, you got to show out now.
Sir.
Ready.
What's that?
Honestly, it felt like my son graduated high school. My son did something, man. It was like I was in tears inside. It was something very emotional and excited for him, man. Because I knew how hard he worked, but I knew that this 40 is so important, especially for his position. And it was just something, man. I just ran to him like, man, we're going to Clemson, Alabama, wherever you want to go after this. So it was just something that was just a surreal moment for myself.
Thank you.
look at playing both safety too.
But like I'm gonna put my mindset ready to do it if I need to. And then if I don't, I don't, but I'm mentally ready to do it.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes.
Hey,
watching the ships roll in, and then I'm watching the moon.
This is what I'm about to tell you, something really real right now, man. I hate to say this, what I'm about to say, because you're going to have to make a decision. And I know you really want to put the workout right now. But I just spoke with a linebacker coach, man. They looking for certain builds, and it doesn't even matter what you do type of deal. So I think that really, if you ask me, you need to save yourself for the fourth.
For the fourth.
Whereas 20 that's coaches there. I know that you're going to have 3-4 camps. I'm trying to tell you, bro. He just told me. He said, man, don't waste his time.
Yeah.
And he was like, not that you're not a good player, but they defense, you don't fit there. And I'm telling you, don't do it, man. Listen to me.
So I kind of went to go talk to one of their coaches that I know very well, Coach Sal, the linebacker coach. And I was so excited. I ran up to him. So I got one of the best prospects from Europe. I think you guys would really be interested in him. And he kind of looked at me and said, sorry, coach, I wouldn't waste his time or your time. He just don't fit our size and profiles we want in our athletes, in our linebackers. So I would say it was kind of disappointing, but at the same time, we can't. This is how recruiting goes, bro. So we got to kind of live the fight another day.
Very hard, very intense, but great workout. Was an experience.
So we walked out of Nick Saban's office. I mean, he basically told us if this was a few months early, I mean, he would have a scholarship right now. But right now, we're kind of full at the position. But I wanted to show you guys respect enough to bring you in our office to show you what type of performance and type of kid you have. And if anything opens up, we'll be the first to contact you guys because we love the way Jairo plays the game.
He was in the office with Nick Saban. You already know what time it is. He did it. You know what I'm saying?
No, I'm saying.
That's what it is, man.
Turn up,
I'ma see
man.
You, parlay. Peace out.
Oh, let's go. Let's get up out of here.
Oh. It's nasty. Mm-hmm. I'm so young, like to swear.